Previously on Minecraft Story Mode.
Old friends come in and move out of life, while new friends show up to fill the spaces left behind. We might not like it, but eventually everyone learns that nothing can escape change forever. No matter how fraught with danger it may seem, the lure of adventure cannot be denied. Sometimes the danger itself is the pull. Some heroes just want to be the one to discover the next ancient secret, to wield strange new powers. This new threat was more personal than any that had come before, and the fight for their lives shook the foundation of everything they thought possible. But in the end, the town was saved. The heroes had won the day. And everyone could believe, for just one moment, that maybe things really hadn't changed at all. And then, that moment passed.
Jack's eye wasn't enough for it.
I wish to speak with Jesse, the gauntlet bearer.
What's going on?
Where'd it come from?
Sorry, you must be thinking of a different town because there's no one here named Jesse.
Oh, it's so cute when you tiny adventurers lie. Come, speak with me face to face.
Oh boy.
Admin? Have you ever heard of such a thing?
Jesse? What's going on here?
Gauntlet bearer? That's all rather suspicious, isn't it?
Everybody run! Hide! That's the admin and he could destroy us all!
Well, if that admin thing wants Jesse, we should just let him have his way!
What? Sacrifice Jesse?
No way! No way!
You're going to fix this, right, Jesse?
You won't let it destroy Beacon Town, will you?
Oh, I'm sure Jesse must have thought of something.
Don't worry, everyone. I'm gonna try talking to it.
Okay. Diplomacy. Nice. That sounds good.
I would like to proceed, Gauntlet Bearer. Do not test my patience.
Guess you should get up there, Gauntlet Bearer.
Clay, coming your way!
Thanks, Nell. Perfect.
Ah, there you are, Jesse. I loved what you did with the Witherstorm. Awesome stuff. This is going to be perfect. You've got the knack.
Why, yes, thanks for noticing.
Seriously, you're a natural. That's why I left you the gauntlet.
You left it?
To tempt you down to the sea temple. But now, your true test begins. It is time you fight. Champion, unless you'd like to see that happen to your entire town. Who knows what I'll do next?
Enough talk, let's fight.
town. Aha! Fighting in broad daylight is boring. Let's add some drama.
Oh, he's powerful.
So much for them. Just you and me now, champion. Don't let them down.
Not good, Jesse. Really not good. Beacon Town is gonna be like one big smash fest to this guy. Ugh. Not even Miss Butter's gonna do anything against that Colossus. We need something bigger. Like
the structure block! Buy me time. I'm gonna plant some arrow towers. That should make Tall, Dark, and Ugly regret smashing my town.
One major distraction coming up. Go, Jesse! Hey, Stoneface! Over here! Yeah, that's right!
Your courage is so much larger than your puny size.
Oh, let's see how you deal with the enchanted deliciousness of Miss Butter!
I could pink my teeth with that blade.
I'll take you down one block at a time!
Clever distraction, Jesse.
Where's the structure block?
Ha ha. Finders keepers. This tiny thing won't save you, Jesse. Not from me.
Okay, this is a little intense, but I guess a giant colossus did follow me
home. Hide and seek is beneath you, Jesse. The champion should be better than this. If you're going to be a coward, Jesse, just give yourself up.
Back at the Sea Temple had the same symbol.
There we are.
All right, Admin, you want to fight? You got one. Here I am.
Looking a little helpless, champion. I'm using champion there sarcastic.
Hey, Rockface! Eat this! Good to see you too.
Yes.
What is that? Quick version, the admin. He built the world or something.
Kay. Are you alright? I mean, he really had you up there.
What took you so long?
Hey, riding to the rescue takes time, all right? I sure hope you got an idea here.
I saw a spot on the back of his head that I'm hoping might be the key to defeating him.
You can't outrun.
Sounds like I better keep him distracted then.
Thanks, Lucas. Be careful.
Come now, Jesse. All this stalling is just making me angrier.
Hey, Blockhead! You want Jesse? You need to go through me first. And I don't think you stand a chance.
You're protecting Jesse. Please. All these interruptions are becoming annoying. That ends now.
Let's see what you got. Hi-yah!
Not in there!
I knew you'd come eventually.
You don't know anything about me.
Where are you?
Hey!
Oh, I'm sorry. Sure would be a pity if... Oops.
No!
You're gonna wish you hadn't done that, Admin.
Oh, boy.
Do you really think you can defeat me, Jesse?
I don't think. I know.
Confidence.
That was really something.
Stay behind me, Stampy!
Ah, don't let the Googlies touch me!
Oh man, these are gonna keep coming in until we get the sun back up.
Any idea how to use it?
Could be super dangerous. How sure are you that this admin guy is gone?
You make a compelling point, Lucas. My hand is still trapped in this freaky gauntlet.
Yeah. Not to be a worrier, but he might not be as dead as we hope.
I'm worried enough for both of us.
Someone should keep an eye on this thing.
Yeah. I can take first watch.
Actually, I'll volunteer. I want to help.
Jesse, I'd say we both do it, but one of us should really get started on the repairs. It's a nice gesture, but maybe you should just let me handle it.
Look, I promise.
Then the minute I see anything out of the ordinary, I'm coming to get you as fast as my hustle sticks will carry me. My legs. Come on, Jesse, I can do this. I know you didn't think I was ready to watch a whole town.
All right, Radar. I officially bequeath on you the title of Clockmaster.
Thank you, Jesse. I solemnly promise to uphold the duties of Clockmaster and to only use my powers for good.
Yeah, good. That's good.
So what are you going to do now?
I figured I'd start with Ruben's memorial. Got pretty trashed.
Oh, man. Well, that's terrible. I'm so sorry. That admin just... no respect.
It'll be all right. Damage isn't too terrible.
That's a really good outlook. And, when I asked you what you're gonna do, I was actually talking about that glove of yours. So I gotta tell you, Jesse, this whole admin thing, it's... well, it's very you, I guess, is what I'm saying. Well, I know you say you're trying to settle down and run Beacon Town, but... it just seems like you can't quit that life, you know? I mean, you don't exactly see Axel and Olivia getting mixed up in stuff like this.
I don't care if that life keeps trying to drag me back. I like Beacon Town. I like helping people.
That's great, then. I mean, the people clearly love you. I didn't say any of that stuff to be mean. Okay, we've had a ton of adventures, and I just want you to be happy. I mean, that's what that little pig wanted for all of us. Now go rebuild his monument. I promised Stampy and Stacy I'd help them get their houses fixed up.
Sounds good. I'll see you later, Lucas. Okay, let's see what we can do for you, buddy. There. Now that is a monument fit for Reuben.
I know I never met Robin.
Reuben.
Oh, right. Righteous. Oh, by the way, Petra was looking for you before. Over that away.
Thanks, Nell.
Aw, come on. You remember Twisting Death Cavern? You couldn't even look at a bat for months, right?
Oh, yes. They all just start to blur together after a while.
Hey, guys, Petra around? Heard she was looking for me.
Oh, yeah, helping Nirm get some stuff, I think. She should be back in a second.
Amazing work fighting that admin fellow, by the way. Just stunning.
Yeah, I would have thought you'd been doing it your whole life. It was artful.
Well, it's not like it was my first battle against an impossible foe.
No?
Witherstorm, I'll get you the book. It's actually a pretty good read. I think I've got a copy back at the shop.
It's a little sad that the legendary Jack, the Iron Sword of Muji Lake, has been reduced to some tour guide.
Voss.
That's why I think this adventure to Twisting Death Cavern is just what you need to...
Shut up.
What you should continue to keep talking about for someday far off.
Yeah, agreed. Love theoretical conversations.
Wow, I thought Jack was a bad liar. But you're pretty terrible at it too, Voss.
Yes, okay, fine. We have a new adventure planned.
Hang on, I missed that last part. If we take that road, it goes through a swamp and a mesa biome? Okay, then it's settled. The earlier we leave, the better.
Wait, you're leaving with these guys?
Yeah.
And that's, that's why we were, being weird before and, talking about, possible stuff.
That's cool, I guess. Is this really that important to you?
Yes, kind of. Jesse, I promise I can explain. I just... Whoa. Wait, what? It's impossible. This isn't a snow biome.
The admin.
The one and only. I had so much fun during our last little battle. Super epic. Just couldn't stay away.
Wait, you're the admin?
Well, that giant...
Prismarine Colossus.
Just a construct. Rolled it up for the occasion. Pretty fun, right? I just thought it'd be a little easier to talk like this. It was kind of cuddly, right?
Fighting a giant statue in the middle of town? Okay, yeah, that was kind of cool.
See? I knew you'd know what I was talking about. See, you four went into my temple, back out alive. Heroes! You're perfect for my creations. Perfect!
Where are you going with this?
Got a new challenge for you. Trust me, you're gonna love it.
Again.
You hear that? That's a diamond-class wave of doom and destruction headed right for town. Pretty good, right? Been working on that one.
Oh, come on, some zombies? So scary.
Ooh, a hero with attitude. I love it. I really do. Ahem. Your town will be trapped in eternal snowy night, forever plagued by deadly waves of mobs, until you recapture that clock.
Which is where?
I'm glad you asked. It's at the tippy top of my awesome, fantastic, super deadly, icy palace of despair. It's simple. Just follow the path. You can't miss it.
Well, that sounds needlessly dangerous.
Oh, it is.
Fine. We accept your challenge. I'm gonna get that clock, and then you're next.
Ooh, that one gave me the shivers. You are legit, Jesse. Very excited.
Why are you doing this? What do you want from us?
Why? Well, because it's fun, obviously. I mean, this is gonna be epic.
What? Oh, come on!
Time to show this goon what the Skitaro crag jumpers do to town destroyers.
You think you've got it all figured out, don't you? Ah, strays! Pesky little consequence of eternal night. And Beacon Town's new neighbors until you take care of that clock. Remember, find the clock, save the town. Bye-bye now.
Ah, we need to protect the people!
Run! Hide, everyone!
I've got a bad feeling more will be on the way soon.
Guys?
Jesse, I am so sorry. I was standing guard, watching it so close, but it just disappeared.
I know. Now the situation is just going to get worse until we get it back.
Yeah, from his icy palace of despair, or whatever.
Wherever you're going, I'm coming too. I was given the title and the power of Clockmaster. If it's to keep Beacon Town safe, I'll do anything.
Really? Just do me a favor and try to stay out of danger, okay?
Okay. I'll try not to be a burden.
All right, everyone, we've got a clock to find.
Can't let you come along on this one, old friend. I promise, I will come back.
Just protect the town while we're gone, all right?
Is that thing gone?
Yeah, for now. I mean, block this up after we leave, would you?
On it.
Yes, we will defend Beacon Town with our very lives.
Thanks, guys. Bye, Nurm.
We're all counting on you.
I wish I knew more about whatever their quest is.
I don't mean to sound suspicious, but do we really think the admin is going to keep his word about this clock?
Yeah, I don't exactly get a trustworthy vibe off of him.
I don't know. I mean, I thought he seemed sincere. Why set all this up if he wasn't going to really let us fix things?
Yeah, well, color me skeptical.
Jesse, can we, talk?
I'll just walk a little more over here.
Oh, right. Me too.
About that trip with Jack. I promise it's not like it seems. It's just a little trip. A little time away from Beacon Town. I don't know. Find myself?
You didn't invite me. You didn't even tell me until I caught you.
I thought you would be busy with all the rebuilding and everything. I really am sorry that it happened this way. I was just so excited to be hanging out with real, hardcore adventurers again. Especially because I was worried that you didn't need me anymore.
So you decide the best idea is to ditch me?
See, this is why it would have been so much easier if you hadn't found out like this. It's just... everything's so different from when we first became friends. Everything's... changed. Lucas, Axel, Olivia, they all changed too. They found what made them happy. Their thing. But me? I still haven't found mine. Do you know how hard that is? How that feels?
I mean, if I'm honest, it does seem like adventure is your calling. You know, the open road.
Right? That's kind of what I thought too.
Luna?
Is that a scarf on that llama?
Huh. Think she ran away again?
Excuse me. Speaking for the group, you guys know a llama?
Where'd she come from?
This is Luna. She's kind of cute, right? We returned her to her owner, Stella.
She is cute, isn't she? Everyone get away from my llama.
No.
Jesse, my rival. Should have known I would find you here.
Yeah, I'm still really not your rival, really.
So you say, and yet here we still meet.
Okay. What is going on here?
Lucas, this is Stella, the leader of Champion City. Jack, Voss, and Radar.
Jack, was it? As in the legendary champion?
So, what exactly are you doing here, Stella?
My beautiful city is currently covered in a hideous coat of snow. That's what. I came out to investigate, and surprise, surprise, it's you. If you're smart, you'll undo whatever it is you did and put things right again.
Just... wow.
Pretending to be a hero again? Just like back in your treasure room?
I... no! Just... I am going to fix it.
Oh, well, I believe we have it well covered, miss. We're on our way to find a mighty adversary and set things right.
All right. Let's say I believe you. I suppose I'll just have to find a way to fix it. It's my world, too, after all. You'll see, I'll fix it all on my own. I don't need any of you losers.
Whoa, the moon is stuck.
Okay, that's freaky.
So, Stella, you were saying?
I was saying that maybe I'll stick around for a bit, just to keep an eye on you.
You know, I've been thinking about it, and I totally agree that adventure is probably the closest I've got to a thing. But did this adventure really have to include Stella?
You okay, Radar?
Yes, totally fine.
Guys, shh, we need to keep an eye. Whoa.
I'm actually kind of speechless right now.
Man, and it's all ice?
Astounding, I know.
I'm right there with you, Jack. That is incredible.
It's like I was telling you, Radar. Never a dull moment.
Hey, found the clock.
perfect. But how are we gonna get up there?
Well, the admin mentioned challenges. I'm guessing there's gonna be, like, obstacles or something when we get there.
Wait, do I have this right? Are you telling me that this admin is so powerful, he built all of this instantly?
You sound almost jealous.
Almost? Of course I'm jealous of power like that. Power is how the world is run, little man. It's what people respect, what they listen to.
Yeah, I'm actually jealous too. Can you imagine being able to build something like that? Just like that?
Aw, look at us. Maybe we're not so different after all.
Ugh. Stella, you'll never change.
Oh, I thought I recognized you. You're the quitter who used to work on my inventory management team.
Wait, do you two know each other?
I used to live in Champion City.
What?
I don't know what he told you to get on this little team, but I don't think he even knows how to use a sword.
Oh, you don't know anything, Stella, so zip it.
Ooh, how do you put up with that little voice of his, Jesse? I know I never could.
If I remember correctly, Stella, I saw a certain someone pretending to be another certain someone, and she wasn't so good with a sword either.
Oh, really? You act so high and mighty, but you really are just a bully sometimes. You know that? Come on, Luna.
Thanks, Jesse. I appreciate that. I'm not the person she thinks I am anymore. I've changed. And I can prove it. I can be different. Braver. If that's what the situation requires, I'll do it.
Just try not to get killed, okay, Radar? I want everyone to get home alive.
I'll make sure it's at the top of my to-do list.
Would you look at that?
Haven't seen anything that grand since the last time I visited the overcompensating builders of Igesh.
No kidding!
Oh boy, my favorite, mystery levers.
Okay, what's going on?
Aha! Hello, everyone! please gather around. Don't be shy.
Here we go again.
Oh, look how many of you there are. Lovely. Your choice of company, I don't know. I mean, this place is really for the best of the best. Not, how do I say this, losers?
Mr. Admin, mighty sir, I'm Stella, founder of Champion City. Maybe you've heard of me?
No, never. It's actually perfect, Champion. I can see you all have dreams of greatness. It's very cute. This construct before you, it's meant to see who's worthy of that greatness. Separate the strong from the weak. So, we'll see how your little companions do, eh?
You watch it, Admin.
I am totally stoked.
Are we really sure what we're getting ourselves into?
Come now, don't be that way. This is all for you. New creatures of my own design, as well as mining fatigue at every turn. Wouldn't want you cheating, of course. I don't like rule breakers. It's simple. You all want to get to that clock, but only the best of the best get to partner up with me in the future. But that could be you. Cook this place up just for you. I mean, it's pretty... Well, I was going to say pretty cool, but... With the whole ice motif, that just seems like I was going for a lame pun, so... Anyway.
I'll give you one thing, Admin. This place is pretty spectacular.
That's what I like to hear! I knew you'd understand. Oh, I am just ecstatic that you see things my way. Thrilled! So, how about we get this show on the road?
Nice landing.
It's nothing. It's just my perfect reflexes and photographic muscle memory.
Well, that's it then. The way is shut.
Yes. Now I suppose the only way out is through.
Yeah, and smashing that clock. Well, we're not all going to be smashing the clock.
Say what now?
You heard the admin. He only wants the best of the best. And that's going to be me.
Oh, you've got to be kidding.
Sorry, handsome. Might as well quit now.
Nuh-uh. No way, Stella. I'm taking you down.
Oh, I knew you were my rival, Jesse. Wow. It's amazing.
You're his little buddy, Jesse. You know anything about this partnership he's offering?
Imagine everything you could create, everything you could do with a prize like that.
I know that it sounds amazing and that I want it.
Oh, really? Come on, Luna. Enough of these losers. We've got treasure to find.
Hey.
Treasure sniffing llama.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, tell your friends.
Hey now.
Oh, that poor llama.
What?
Hey, don't treat Luna like that. She obviously hates it.
I think I know my darling Luna a little better than you do. Let's go, Luna.
Well, that is certainly a woman who knows what she wants.
Are you kidding? She's nuts.
Well, no one knows better than me that the admin's traps and constructions mean business.
You've got a point there, old friend. I don't want to see anyone else get hurt.
Yes. And it's like the admin said, not everyone here might be up for the task. I mean, no offense by it, just stating facts.
Radar and Lucas can handle themselves.
Yeah? Yeah.
Yeah!
Fine. But if something happens to them, that's on you, not me. Come with me, Jack. Let's try and scope this place out.
I'm gonna go talk to them.
Well, I have never been so offended. Not in my whole life.
Yeah, that wasn't the coolest.
Wasn't the coolest? Oh, no. Misfiling your acacia wood during Material Organization Week isn't the coolest. That was a stripe too far. But just because I'm not some sword-swinging meathead, they think they can just walk all over me.
Excuse me, Radar?
They think they look at me and my skinny little arms and they think they
Radar?
Know me. They think they know me? Well, they are wrong. Dead wrong! I mean, I have been an embarrassment sometimes, but it stops here. It ends today. And I guess I'm done. Sorry.
I need you to remember that out there, the world is stuck in eternal night. There are a lot of scared people back in Beacontown who are counting on us.
You're right. We were talking and decided that it would be best for everyone if Radar stays here with Lucas while we go get the clock.
That's it, Luna, darling. She's got the clock sent. Later, losers.
We're wasting time.
Wait. The admin built this whole place to eliminate people, right? Trick them? Sure, it looks like Luna found something, but that's
just what the admin wants us to think.
You saw the llama!
Jesse, you're coming, right?
We could really use a hand over here.
I gotta go with them. Be safe, okay?
If you're sure.
Woohoo! I knew you'd make the smart choice!
That's one way to get where you're going.
Everybody okay?
Definitely. What a rush.
I'm all right. I'm okay. I am so sorry. I'm okay, really. Just getting my adventure legs. I'll be better in a minute.
Hey, it's okay. Take the time you need.
Yeah, we'll wait.
No. Oh, it's not so bad. I can do this.
I gotta say, if you're having a hard time with the minecarts, you might not like what comes next. Hello there! It's me again, your friendly neighborhood admin. Pretty proud of this challenge, not gonna lie. I was feeling very inspired by the concept of karma. I'll tell you why, but... well, that spoiled the surprise. I'm sure you understand, right? Real heroes live for surprises. Unexpected dangers.
Oh, that's all right. Tell me. I'm cool with spoilers.
I just told you I'm not going to spoil the surprise. Just play along here. Let's just say I hope you're feeling good about your archery skills, Between you and me, though, champion, I'm less worried about your archery than I am about your choice of companions. Let's see if I can shuffle the board a bit, Give you another pair of hands to help out.
Where? How?
He's no Jesse. But he's better than that other guy, right?
Oh, dear.
All you need to do is activate the shooting gallery, hit all the targets, and the door will open. Easy, right?
Okay, but what are those pumpkin heads for?
Don't worry, Jesse. We'll figure it out.
Arrows. Perfect for shooting targets with. Now I just need a bow. Time to meet your maker. Always good to have string around.
Some targets, huh?
He really reminds me of us. You know, back in the day, eager to make his mark, always ready for whatever's around the next corner.
I still worry about him. He's got a lot to learn.
So did we. Man, sometimes I still can't believe how far we've come.
Come on, how do you turn this stupid thing on?
Looks like he needs our help. Got everything I need. Just need to get this thing moving. All right, Button. You're mine.
This is so cool!
All right, Lucas. Show the admin who he's messing with. Easy. Well, that was a little tougher.
Jesse, you're good. I'm definitely gonna steal some of those moves.
Here comes round three.
Fine shot. Almost feels like I made this challenge too easy for you. Oh, wait. No, I'm totally messing with you. Time for level two.
Hang on! What are you... Oh, man.
Look out!
Boss!
Jesse! Take care of yourself!
Way, guys, follow me.
Here.
Ah!
Oh, come on!
radar. Take this, help Lucas hold off those golems. Stage 3!
Wasn't your fault, Radar. Voss has to be somewhere in this place. We'll find him. Taste my bravery?
Well, I figured it was appropriate. That was intense. Would it be weird for me to go in for a hug? Because I'm kind of feeling the hug vibe right now. Maybe? Oh, wow. You're a good hugger.
Petra!
Hey, have you guys seen Voss? One second he was with us, and the next, gone!
Hello? Help! A little help here?
No, 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 no,
no! No one deserves this. Not even Stella. She might be a bit stuck up, and she doesn't really treat anyone that nicely, but she's a person, too.
Right now, finishing is all that matters. We get to that clock, we save everyone. Including Stella.
Okay, no, 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 no. This is all wrong, people, wrong! You're not supposed to help each other. The losers are supposed to lose. Like spectacles over here. There was no way Radar would have fought his way out of that room without you. You should have just cut him loose. Jettison that baggage. Seeing someone like you held back by that? Oh, painful.
Fine, then just let him out of here. Set him free if you really don't think he should be here.
Fine, you convince me. It's not often I give second chances. one condition, though.
Hey, no! No! Oh, man, not good!
No!
He's so small!
Let's see how our bucko does on his own, eh? What do you think the chances are? Without... Just
you...
Not good. We have to do something.
We'll have to maneuver past all that cacti. Floating lava? That's crazy!
There's a door.
Go for the door!
He's not gonna make it. We can't just stand here.
Jesse!
Here we go. Radar, the door!
Jesse, I just had a thought. Maybe I can do this. Maybe I am a hero.
Told us to go through his stupid challenge, but maybe we can find another way.
Did anyone...
Luna? That llama can get to the other side of the wall, so can we. Yeah, we're never punching through that. Anyone got anything to make a pickaxe?
I have some sticks.
3 diamonds!
That sounds like a diamond pickaxe to me. Anyone got anything to make a pickaxe?
I have some sticks.
3 diamonds!
That sounds like a diamond pickaxe to me.
Going up.
And our friends went up. And that's where we're headed to.
Hate to point out the obvious, but we can't climb. Oh, no.
Thank you.
Weird dreams, Radar.
Sorry. Still a little groggy from going through all those pipes. Pretend I didn't say anything.
Jesse.
You might want to hurry. We've got monsters incoming.
Come on, Radar. We gotta get you out fast.
Okay. Okay.
I got a feeling they won't be gone for long.
Jesse, hello?
Stella.
I could have found that clock, obviously, but there was some signage that was very confusing. And, well, I, you know, wound up here. Kept hoping the admin would drop by so I could explain the confusion, but when we do talk, you better believe that he's gonna realize I am the perfect friend and partner for him. It will be divine.
Stella, would you please just stop talking already?
Fine. Enough chit-chat. How about you get me on out of here?
You are unbelievable.
Thank you.
Okay, fine. Just don't make me regret it, all right?
Knew you would. Our fates are intertwined, after all. Who are either of us without the other?
Ow.
Way to go, Jack. Come on, guys. Let's get up to him.
Time, you nitwit!
The real Voss would never have survived in my sea temple that long.
I am disappointed, Jesse. You obviously just don't have what it takes to really be my friend, my partner. Such a pity. Such a waste.
Now, hang on there. Let's just start over and discuss this friend thing from the top.
No, I'm afraid it's too late for that.
Excuse me, Mr. Admin, sir. I just wanted to say that I would love to be your partner.
But you lost.
Technically, yes. But unlike them, I actually appreciate what you're offering.
You don't say.
Stella, I don't know if you've noticed, but what he's offering is absolutely crazy. You can't really mean this.
No, but I do, Jesse. Jesse, I really appreciate you saving me. Love ya. Mean it. But you obviously don't understand the magnitude of what this paragon is offering.
Huh. Stella, was it?
Yes, sir.
See, she may not have the skills, but that is a terrific attitude. Your attitude, on the other hand? Oh, well, there's nothing that hurts more than broken hopes. I made this for you. Just for you. And how do you repay me? You cheated! How could you do this to me?
I don't know, let me see. Because you're crazier than a poisoned potato!
See, now you're just being rude and lashing out, and I don't care for it. I gave you so many chances! What? It hasn't all been to waste. No. You might not be worthy. What? Technically, Jack here was the winner. Oh, don't get me wrong. There are quite a few flaws we'll have to work through, but we'll get there. In time?
No, you can't!
Ooh, Jack, where did he go?
Oh, don't even worry about it. It's not for a loser like you to worry about where the cool people go.
Jack, no!
Shh. Like I said, not for you guys to worry about.
Let's be reasonable now.
Ugh, you really are just hopeless! I'm done letting you make me feel bad. I prefer to feel good. And I'm gonna feel real good when I send you two to a place where you'll never see the light of day. Ever again.
No!
Must be a special class of trouble to end up here. The admin, well, this is where he sends the people who he has special plans for. You may have noticed, it's not a very nice place. And the people? Well, they're not very nice either.